Hello everyone and welcome to the episode 2 of my Let's Play series in Minecraft and Players mods. So, I start off with this nice rainy day to check out what the quarry has been doing between the two cassettes. You can see it's doing a pretty good job. You can see there are plenty of forest in there. You can see just after it is resided, but we have one there too because the quarry isn't running the system. And so I got nice and full already, flint guides around and cover, so it's kind of nice. I did a couple of changes, so I refilled the engines. I just used 20 feet to build this. I'm going to run a bit longer. I've been doing other stuff, like I added a bit more glowstone in this room because monsters are spawning. I placed a lot of torches outside to avoid too much monsters at night, and I expanded this room because I depend this episode on working a bit more on peace. Let's see, I didn't do much things this time. And one first thing I would do is start working on my industrial B branch because I want to be able to produce propolis pretty soon. I will need it. And automatos and stuff. I got enough, but it won't come anymore. One first thing I want to do is a new appearance chest. Which is to do the mess. I'll take all those good drones. This. And throw them. I think I got them just gonna do drones for this time. Yeah, I don't need more, so I need to take care of the rest and I need to automatically get those honeycombs processed. So first thing I wanna get going is I want to send a shield. I won't make another for them, I'll just take the one that's here on this potential. So I had a lot of things, processed stuff, and so I'm bingo. So, this is the camera. And I will put this in a huge somewhere. Here, soon is pretty nice, I think. That's not needed for now. So just put the potential there, the centrifuge there, and the wrench to reorient the pit engine right way like this. And of course I'll be using regulators to get there. So I have to find where it come from. Next, of course, I need a bit more tubes and a couple of machines. Shouldn't be too complicated. So let's go there. I threw my swaps there. I don't know if I can. This here. Also put this here. Right now, I need a pair of chests. I should have a filter. Yeah, I got water filter. Right now, I got a relay, something I want, and a regulator, so just crashed one real fast. Right? So as you recall, regulator is made not really hard at capstone. So I need this, and I need more of this, but I got nice amount of footstones, so can we find the craft all this? Not really, there will be a couple of them. But one thing I wanted to do though is take Nebulizer and everything that happens. Put some hangers in there and then I'll use a couple of these. Indoors and then behind us. This one, I know it's modest. But I don't know for this one. Let's see. It's a pure red forest. I'll have to read it as made of sugar something. Put it right here. This one should be. Okay. I'm gonna display the rest. I want to try and get a common one. To get try and get the industry's range. Maybe another one, but I don't know. So let's be first and others. Try and get it. So now I can make that kind of stuff. And while this thing cooks, I can make myself a transposer real fast. Sail down the same way as this. Pretty easy to do. Transposer. Next sure thing I have to do is make a timer. So I can still get plenty of some wafers in there, so I should learn to craft. Like this. Two redstone torches. Yes, I need a stone piece that I want to pack. Stone pieces like this. Stone pointer, pink effect. Now, get all this going. And get myself another time. Good. Now, this thing cooked. First, I must get myself some animals. No, I need some purple flowers first. Something like here. And I need a nice amount of tips, so I got to craft that. Also, so now I'll just take the stack. Craft a stack of tips. Use a waste to craft. Regulator, it is done that way. So, okay, before that, I need to use it again. So, I need a wood pressure plate, a little tubes, pressing it. Plus, I read the beefer and wood plates. And now, I can do the regulator. And dispose of the rest. The first, read the wafer, and then see. The first, just I'm going to just put this because I don't need it on me right now. I'm resting that stack. So I pretty much got everything I need at that point. So you can see it's starting to be night. I need to sleep because that rain is not. Just keep taking of it. This is not that my square because that's what I need. Ooh, bear. What a nice day. There's a creeper in the mountain again. That happened. So I need a transposer there. Or you want that like this? Not what I want. And I need pneumatic tubes. Ah, damn. Up to there and there I need a regulator. Except if I do that. No, I'll do it that way. I want it like this. And the burr. Not what I'm Yes, good. And then grab some pizza. Pizza, ouch. Bit is in a chest. So, 8 is a lit because I want to keep 8 in this chest. I mean, in this engine. And, nope. Not what I meant to do. It's basically 8 there. So, I'll tell it to keep 8 and then a little bit more of it. Just to be sure that I need it. And I said 1. Decent gin. Well, I'm preparatively as soon as I place that timer. The timer will be pretty slow because if I get too fast, there will be a lot of bit going back and forth and waste of it. So I don't need it to run very fast. So I just tell it to go every 10 seconds. That's to avoid any waste of it. And now I can put that, get dirt and stuff. To make it hidden. Good. Last thing I need to do is get it on my rested signal. If that thing is full, it should emit some signal though. Oh, I knew it. I was thinking of that, and some protectors would do it. The way it works, because red power is 8 sensitive, and not really smart with first engines and machines. So I have to put the regulator that way instead. And I have the tubes like this. And then it will work. Of course, the obvious problem is that it's less easy to get going. To hide this. No, I need a grass block to make it completely hidden. But well, I'll just do it with dirt. But not very good. Because grass won't grow on those dirt covers. So it will always look like this. But for now, it's not a problem. But now what I can do is just take care of this cover and then. I'll open this. I just need a lever. This, and I can activate the engine. And also, I cover how this thing works. There. Now, it should be fully functional. And I can repair it. Now it's doing nothing, so I need more stuff going. Alright, so let's do it that way. I need to filter out the honeycombs. So obviously I need a filter. First. So let's grab some things. I'm moved. At this point I will need 2 filters. And then a new machine, if you can call it like this, an NBC, for my centrifuge. Alright, so I need a filler, and I need another one, so I'll just craft one. Just complete stuff. Like this. And not this, I need a piston. Stop being annoying. So just put this in there. Take this and craft a piston. I mean the filter. So I got a filter. I will need another timer. So let's craft it. God. And I get the timer going. Great. And I'll just put this in there. This is not a problem. Put back my bill laser in there. And I need to place it on the door, by the way. Thank you. And next thing I need to go doing is... I need a wood farm pretty soon. I need this. I need a chest. Yeah, I really need some more wood. And with some iron like this, I can make myself a hopper. From BC 3.1.6. I think it's pretty awesome. It looks very good. Basically what it will do, it will keep up to 4 stacks of items in there. And as soon as there is place in the machine below it, it will place them automatically in. So that serves as some kind of overflow thingy. It's also useful if you have multiple types of things going in the same machine. For example, it now only got army combs, but when I get more species of bees, I get different types combs. And they can just stay there while the other one process. I'll probably get more centrifuges anyway. So first I place a door before I forget, and place more torches inside. Alright, done. So what I do basically at the point is I put folders in those chests. And I'll do it. And then. Like this. So of course I still need my old screwdriver. Then around the way. Oh, not the way. That's silly because this thing here. I accidentally clicked. Not what I meant to do. There. I can take this one. Just like this. All go this line up there to here. Of course, over this and the covers. My demon says there. There's something that looks good. So stone will do. Good job. There and there. And it doesn't look very good, you know. But that's fine. Of course I'm looking forward to some of those things. Filters out of onicoms. I think I would change the pipes I used there. Instead of normal pipes I want at least redstone tubes. To make the system a bit more compact. I can simply put the timer there. Ah, that's lovely. I'll put it there. Just need one thing, I need a red jacket wire. I have to run up to my storage room. Off fast. And find some. I won't have to pull out this stuff pretty fast because the fuse still needs a couple seconds to process each gun, so the 2 second space delay is pretty good. So yeah, we'll start working. Just put them in the hopper and the upper immediately turns them there to a centrifuge and start processing the stuff. So it's working. At that point they can simply close the thing. And to make it look nice, I can put... What's the help of this? Hollow color. There. Perfect. or anything in this line as up to but the filters and tabs, I'll be able to process automatically all this stuff, and I need to get it out of here. The thing I need a couple chests to stack it. One double chest will do fine. Anyway, I can't do any more. I will just throw him directly there. I won't do normal stuff. Directly, I'll do. I'll do this. Do the transposer. I'll do the piston real fast there. Not to run back. Run back and forth. Piston. Oh, just enough sword to get it to a transposer. Like this. Oh, I have to use my space forever. Take this. Get this in there. It covers to avoid any contact with unwanted things. And you know what? 1 second. Because to produce it more stuff, so to be sure it takes everything out. It will throw everything in the chest. So yeah, now I got automatic bees. Even more automatic than it was before. There's still one thing I need to do though. I need to take care of the drones. That's the thing I'm gonna get going with bees this episode. Because if I let this, the chest will overflow with some things. And it will be pretty ugly to see. So I just need to get myself from the bullcrap 2 more diamond pipes. I still want propolis, I cannot use the special pipes just for this purpose, so I have to use diamond pipes. So there you go. Take a drill. And I will have a way to dispose of these. And for this I need a special type of pipe. So I need to get it crafted. I need just one thing there. An egg sack, a glass piece. It's time I get myself. I think it's in the center. Yeah. Void pipes. So then I clamped in the additional pipes for bullcraft. But if you have bullcraft 3.1x6, it's directly put into PC. And that thing just erases any items that go in it. So on the white path we'll go. Oh no, wait. That's not good. Forgot. It first have to go in the PLE, then we can erase it. The diamond pipes will go there instead. Yeah, more logical. I can put the white pipes there. And on the white path we'll go the drones. So any drones that remains will be just thrown into the void. Disappear basically. So now it is full automatic. Any other drones? I can put them like this. So, well, I just put a bit more there. And that's all. That's full automatic. Oh, and the man. I have to take care of it. Mind the pills is always welcome. Alright. Let's do something else. Alright, so I still have a couple meds to do to start something, and one thing I wanted to start that I still haven't started yet mod, and that is railcrafts. I still haven't done anything with railcraft, and I wanted to get some things going at a point. So I'm just putting some things there, because I don't need anymore. And I got a nice amount of coal. I think that's the moment to make some special furnaces. But for special furnaces, we'll need a nice quantity of clay, and I will be hunting clay off camera. So see you later. Alright, just come back from my lake. Getting some clay. So I got four stacks and a half. So I'll cook them using those induction furnaces. And I need a nice amount of bricks to get what I need. So I'll be back when it's cooked, because it's gonna take a whole time. Yeah, actually, while that happens, I wanted to get myself a nice amount of sand. And so I pretty much have no sand there, and no sand there, too. So I have to get to the desert and get myself a nice amount of it. Just before I do that, I'm gonna cook this shovel to get myself back and everyone gets. That's a zombie drop if you want to know. Alright, so it should be there on. And I got this dirt here to get myself a nice amount of sand. Just before I do that, I pop a portal there to get back fast. Alright, see you later. Alright, I'm back and I got everything I need now. So my bricks, were cooked there. And now, with the help of the project table, I'll be able to make a A to make cook oven bricks. There you go. See, it isn't quite enough. Same. Well, we got a little circles. Okay, this is the place for the men. Glass. Alright, so I got a nice amount of cooking bricks. So I can have lots of them. So I'm going to choose a place to blood then. Nice place where I will hang out on this line. This car. So there's no pictures. Just cook on this, but next you have to make the cook oven itself. My cook oven is done with this structure. 3x3x3 is a hole in the center. And I'm going to put it on my cook oven. It takes 28 bricks for one. Think about it, this aircraft is what it isn't. So what I will do is do both. Oh, not in this place. Well, in that case, we'll just do that. And this to craft there, and well, crafting. I forgot a T and a F. And oof. There you go. Rest of the good gold goes there, and wood there. Not adding to put there. Right. This night is falling in rain to bed to take care of this rain, because it's starting to rain. There was a lot of rain this last days. Right. Now it's going to rain. I can work on this problem. So how they work is that you need coal. Only thing you need to make them run is coal. So I put two stacks of them. Because I got two cock ovens. And simply put them in the left slot. And they will automatically begin their work. What we'll do is, it's a pretty long process, and every coal will be turned into coal cock there. Every piece of coal will be turned into coal cock. Coal cock is a type of fuel that is twice as powerful as coal and can be used in the process of making steel in the blast furnace. So pretty good. And for every two piece of coal, it will produce one bucket worth of crushed oil and put it in there. And the crushed oil is what is needed to produce wood ties, and wood ties are used to make multiple things. Oof, it's especially to make a wooden rail bed, and wooden rail bed are used to make pretty much all normal rails. And other rails too. So it's very you have to get the crystal to it. Now I don't want to make it automatic for now because I don't have much coding for this. So. And I want that to check on something. But I'd like to use something new from Rarecraft and beta, and then very cool. I got to check if I can do it right now or not. First, I don't have beta. Got this. And it's called the iron tanks. So, the iron tanks are made with 3 and this thing, and they're crafted with iron plates that are crafted like dash sash. Oh, now it's pretty good. Oh, they're pretty cheap to make actually, so I'm happy. And can I do this then? I need a rolling machine first. But I don't have any wood, so I'll just use the birch wood. It's fine for now. I'll get me a nice stack of these. And I got to make myself some pieces to make a rolling machine. The rolling machine is a very craft item that lets you craft multiple things directly linked with Rollercraft. I'll show you. So I need to replace RCP with Birch. And just put get myself 10 pistons. Not too much because I want to keep some wood if I need it. And the last one because I will be using more wood later. And you craft it like this. You need a workbench, working table, 4 pistons on the side, and 4 iron ingots. Because that's a rolling machine. Be careful not placing a rolling machine in your chest, because a rolling machine acts like an automatic crafting table. Meaning that you can put stuff in there and it will stay in the rolling machine. And if the elements of the rolling machine are in the chest near it, it will take the resources of the chest. So I'll put it there, so it's fine. I got my rolling machine. And I'll need this amount of iron to get myself those iron plates. So let's see. Two stacks will be enough, I think. But it's for quite a nice long time. also be used to make things needed for creation of rails and stuff. You can see it took iron from this project table. So even there it's not a good idea, you must put it even further from, you have to put it away from any inventory actually. So there we would be fine. So I got myself a nice amount of those plates. It's just a little surplus of iron and stuff, that's fine. I got the slabs I should take care of. This. Alright, next I need around glass plates. I think I'll use some around there. None actually, I think I used them all. So, just doing this. And iron tanks are also a structure and you need multiple blocks. You need tank walls, tank choke, and tank valve. So first I will craft valve. I need a lever for this. Valve are inputs or outputs of an iron tank, and they can be used in construction walls, bullcraft, water pipes. They are not really needed to make an iron tanks, but of course if you want a nice automaton with those waterproof pipes, you have to use them. Else the iron tanks have a input and output slot to be used with liquid containers, so you don't really need them. So I have to craft one of these. It's made like this, of course, like so. Wait, it isn't. Oh, it is made already. Oh, iron bars also. So I have to use the iron I had there. Not very much. Projections, all that stuff. I got my thing valves. Next, I need George. George actually the transparent part of iron tanks and lets you see a level of liquid. I don't know if you really need them, but they're cheaper to make than iron tank wall, so it's always a bonus. I don't know. I missed. Two of them. And next, it's all about. I will do it in projectable. Making the walls. And it's not made like this. Oh, it's only four. So yeah, I'll just do this. There. I think that's fine. Put everything in it. Put the rest directly in the my rollercoaster chest. And I can build this iron tank. What's cool with iron tank is that they're very moldable in size. You can make them pretty much any size. So I'll do this only sized one. And the basic structure is like this. I'll make 5x5, I guess. Very mobile, you need, and I should better do this level with the ground. It's like you have to make a magnet. That's how you make the iron things. And you will see that they're all of them. They're better than multiple things. They're also making more expensive to make. Put one valve here. And I'll start putting the jauge there. I don't know how big it would be. I think I will need more of those. Yes. Yeah, I'll just pick one of those walls. So it's really expensive. I don't know why it's too much. So if you want to make those things, just be sure to get those iron. I continue to make it. depending on the size of it, it's like a very large amount of liquids. So I'll put another valve there. Now, just putting up the top things. There you go, and now it has the right structure and automatically turns into an air tank. So that's the basic structure, you can expand it however you want. And let me put the valve at the right position now. And this one. And this. And one of them for inside. There. So now you see it's recognized. This is a nice huge tank. And it's also like a grill as well. I see the value of grill there. I think 1,000 equals a bucket, I think. So. Now I have to pump the grill oil out of it. Now what's better, I should put the valve there. And those. Let myself some waterproof pipes. Waterproof pipes, if you only have BC, they're made by cooking cactus to get those cactus green and then craft them into a pipe waterproof. But if you got forestry, you can instead of cactus use beeswax and craft it directly into pipe waterproof. And then you just craft that pipe waterproof with small pipes. And you will get yourself waterproof pipe that can contain liquid. Pretty cool if you ask me. So I got that wooden waterproof pipes and I need some golden pipes. Golden pipes when used with waterproofing stuff contains more liquid per pipe. When you use them energy wise, it will have less energy loss of resistance and cobble. So always use gold when you got waterproof and a collective pipe to use. Anyway, you need to use the gold. So just do it. So the rest of the stuff are things you can place back there. Not yet anymore. Last pins I can put there. Iron bars too. Though I'll take that sand and just put it in the addition for this system. Also directly in the same of glass, just to finish doing my pipes. Grass it all I can. Alright, nice, I need wooden engines. So I can get the liquid out. And I didn't notice I already got some of this waterproof pipes, so I just finish planting all the rest of those liquid pipes. Like this. There you go. So I have no wooden engine there. I have to craft them myself. I already got some pistons and that's not a problem. Just need to make myself 4 wooden gears. Also need some glass. Should be some there. All that I cooked. Done that way. Only two. There you go. That's what I need. I wanted a redstone signal to tell them, so two levers should do. And I'm approaching the end of the episode, so I'll just finish that thing and then I'll stop. So you can see by looking at this, you can see there's a 2 million liquid in its storage. So that means I'll be able to hold 2,000 buckets worth of liquid. Pretty large number, if you ask me. So there you go, need engines. Too much. Oh, then you get Ratch. And stop pumping the liquid out, you see? And up. To the valve. And now it will enter this. You can see it will fall into the tank. You can see the liver rays in the tank, and you can see the cool rays up as this thing fills up. That makes it for a nice crystal storage. And the thing is empty. This thing doesn't look empty though. Oh, forgot the lever, I think. No, I just didn't turn it on. Now this was also get the crystal out. For each pulse, it's one bucket worth of liquid that gets out. And center there. Get a nice waterfall and see the crystal being put in the iron tank. You need one valve. You cannot use one valve to get output and input. You need two valves. Each input or output, you need one valve. But if you need not have inputs and outputs, you only need a large tank. But I didn't even need to make a tank that large actually. It's way too large. So I think I'm gonna modify this. About the last bit of the stuff going. And I need to collect the crystal oil button there. Crystal oil you can put in buckets and stuff. But you can use the original way it was made. Oilcraft. Before that it wasn't liquid. So I just produced crude oil and gas crystals. So if you want to get a liquid, you can just put this shit. Now it will take everything. And now I got a little bit left in there and I don't want to waste it, so I'll make a first ray then. Plus I need a glass pane. More piece. And it's called the pipette. And this. Oh, I need two of these. And the point of these items is that it will take any amount of liquid that is inside one bucket that is left inside any machine. Oh, first it will craft. I put it and I have to click on this thing. Oh. Probably it doesn't seem to work with iron things. So I have to waste that a little bit of crystal oil. I think I will just do this. So a bit of crude oil into this. There you go. So now I got a bit less wasted. So now I can destroy it. So I, of course, I think it wasn't saving it. Disappeared. And I can make it less large because I don't need that large. So let's do this. Destroy the walls. Instead of 5x5, I'll do it 3x3. Stick valve there and redo this thing. So to begin. Good, that will do it. Should look better now. As you see, it's very modular. You see now I got an iron tank, but only holds 720 buckets. That's still a lot. So now it's north. And I can put back stuff in there. So see, if it's filled recipients, it will fill the iron tanks. If it's empty, containers, it will fill them. So it's pretty smart. There you go. This thing is filling up again. I really didn't need that much big of tank. This here saves a lot of force. I don't think we'll 56 to be exact. So if I need to build more of those iron tanks. And I'll pretty much never use BC tanks. Only those railcraft tanks because they look very, very cool. And they hold a lot of liquid. I mean, how you want them to run. Because the problem with PC tanks is that they're only stuck on themselves, and if you want to hold lots of liquids, you have to make very high tanks. Well, with those iron tanks, you can make them larger in size, hold way more, put valves wherever you want, so that's very extremely cool feature from Warcraft Beta. Well, I'll get the pipe on me. It will be useful. Most of this disposal we need. And I'll wrap up the episode right now. I sound like an elf. Anyway, so I get the iron tanks now running. I was refilling of crystal tool produced there. You can see there's already some cool cooks produced there. So actually there should be 5 crystal tool buckets. Actually, that's a total of 10 that should be there, so I only lost like 200 of crude oil. Not much problem. You can see there's a huge amount of coal there. So I guess all the coal that I get there are directly to those coal coven. Seems a very good idea to me. I don't know which side they should be buttons into this, but I will do that next episode because it's getting late. Anyway, thanks for watching this episode 2 and see you next episode. I'll be doing some more stuff. Bye.